and welcome back to another Koze Daily Brew. Today I wanted to talk about what self-care September has taught me. We're almost done this season of the Koze Daily Brews, which is wild in itself, but I feel like September actually was a little bit slower of a month than most of the other ones of 2019, and I've enjoyed it a lot because I feel like I kind of dedicated this month going into it as a self-care slash like self-love movement for myself, you know? I think with just the fact that obviously I entered the month like fresh off a breakup, and also just in general too, there's something about September that just like makes me think of just like gold. Maybe because it's kind of like that golden hour right before we lead into fall. Something that I've been trying to be very aware of this year as opposed to other years is just becoming conscious of the fact that other years, Utober is always one of those times where it's a lot of work, you know, you gotta upload daily videos, and they're not like Koze Daily videos, they're like full-on videos. So I decided that going into September, I wanted to really just like self-care, just check in with myself, just like really just hone in and focus on just doing the most soul work, I guess. We're pretty close to the end of September now, and already I feel like September has taught me so much. Taking care of ourselves is so much more than just kind of chasing our goals and filling up like our bank accounts, you know? Self-care has become more of a movement of taking care of not just our bodies, but also our minds and our souls, our spirits, all of that good stuff. And so I feel like that has been a big theme this month. It's been, if I'm just gonna off the cuff, as per usual for this season of September Daily Brews, but I'm just gonna be really frank with you guys. I'm not really gonna pre-process what I'm gonna say. I'm just gonna like jump into kind of how I'm feeling right now. One thing that I think has been an ongoing theme for me this month is almost like releasing control. I feel like if I don't have routines and if I don't have regimens and if I don't have schedules, then I would just be floating about in my own little daydream of the world. That's just kind of how I am. It's one of those things that with time and age, I've kind of grown to appreciate. A lot of the coolest things that I've ever created have come from being a little lost in my thoughts. And that's where like these little sparks of ideas come up. So that's something that I definitely would say is probably also a big theme of September too, is just kind of like going with the flow of just trying to stay conscious and aware of how I was feeling, the tone of my thoughts, and all of that. And one thing that I've noticed, even just from kind of going back into my journals, even just from this month, on the right side of my journal, I always kind of just free write however I'm feeling. And then on the left side, I like to kind of, I put the date, I put the time, I put anything that's kind of going on that's relevant, like any kind of event that I've gone to, any kind of memory from the day. And then at the end of the day, I go back into that same journal post and I write down three things that I'm either grateful for or three things that I feel like I crushed that day. And then I rewrite my mantra that I used at the beginning of the day. For instance, today my mantra is, I don't need anyone's approval but my own. And that was just one that honestly, I didn't know what I wanted my mantra to be today. So I just Googled some mantras and that one really just stuck with me. And I just wrote that all through the day. All into these like wild little apps like The Pattern, CoStar, Daily Horoscope. And they're all based on just like your birth chart and patterns in your life and all of that. And one thing that I've noticed across the board on all of them was just that this was going to be kind of like a peak time of feeling a little bit of, not out of control in a bad way, but just like out of control in the sense of not understanding really why things feel so heightened, and that the whole lesson through it or the process of getting through it was just to kind of not try and understand and just kind of let go and like let it take you and just show up with wherever you find yourself. This is probably one of the, not the only chapter, but one of the most recent chapters of my life that I've ever felt so in tune in a way where I feel like I'm just kind of on my own side. I need to work, I need to be productive, I need to improve on myself and improve on my life. Lately, it's felt like I've been showing up for myself and showing up to do work and showing up for the things that I've set out for with the process or the thought process of this feels right to me, let's see where this goes. And also too, just like I don't need to control the outcome, I'm kind of just here for the journey. And that sounds a little cliche, but it's one of those things that has been a very refreshing feeling. I think that when I am reflective, I'm always kind of looking for areas of improvement. This month, I feel like I've really kind of opened up the doorway of just being a little bit more relaxed with myself and a little bit more of like a cheerleader for myself, in the sense of like, woohoo, like even if I'm kind of having a bad day, but I don't let it affect me as much as I feel I want to. And that to me is the type of progression that I feel like might not seem monumental, in your day-to-day life. It might not seem measurable in your day-to-day life, but you feel it. And when you feel it, even though I'm sitting here telling you about it, it's almost like you don't even need to tell people about it. You don't really even need to share it. It's just something that you're kind of feeling shift within yourself. And that shift is one of the most comforting feelings in the world, because you go from being do to just kind of like be. I feel like it's always been about doing. It's always been about accomplishing. And a lot of the times, I'm not afraid to admit it anymore, there was some things that I feel like I really did solely just to say I did them, rather than I'm doing this for the experience, I'm doing this for the lesson, I'm doing this for release or expression or just so many other things. Lately, I guess it's felt a lot more like the things that I'm doing are for expression and are for just kind of like seeing what happens and just being open to life. And that feeling of taking the driver's seat in your own life, it's almost like you get in to the driver's side of your car and you lift your foot off the gas pedal rather than just slamming it down. Don't get me wrong, I think that there's always gonna be little pockets or little periods of our lives where we do slam it down on the gas pedal. I'm the kind of person that gets like a high off of being productive. You know, you're burning yourself out a little bit from working too hard, or anything else that you notice about yourself that you're maybe just kind of like, ooh, this isn't so good. I think the worst thing you can do is follow that up with like shame and guilt and feeling crappy about yourself. Leaned a little too far, let's lean back a little bit. Leaning back into a balance rather than just being like, oh my God, I've crashed, I've burned, and now I need to burn myself back down to the ground to start anew again. The minute I've noticed myself be out of balance, I almost like then just go, well, whatever. And like, have you guys seen the meme where he just like throws all the papers and then he's like, just kidding, I need these, and he slowly starts picking them back up? That's always kind of been like a thing for me. Like, I feel like I've noticed anytime I go out of balance, I almost just like go, whoop, whatever, and like screw all the papers. And then I pick them all back up again. And this time around, September, I feel like I've noticed that when I'm kind of falling out of balance, instead of throwing my papers in the air, I'm just kind of like, I refile them a little bit, and all of a sudden I'm back into balance. I lean back into it. And not only, I guess, if we're just gonna roll right off of the whole theme of lean back, not only has that been a theme for just leaning back into balance, but I also feel like it's leaning back into life. I don't feel this huge fire under my butt anymore to be chasing something. Ask myself exactly what I'm in such a rush to, what I'm racing so quickly towards, and what destination is it that I think I'm gonna get to where suddenly I'm gonna feel like I can lean back and just relax a little bit. Because there's always gonna be things to do, and there's always going to be places to be, there's always gonna be people you wanna see and things to fill up your time. Like, it's gonna be hard not to find things that are kind of calling for your attention all the time. But if you don't take seconds to kind of lean back, if you will, then that's kind of what I think ends up leading us into imbalances, and what ends up leading us into feeling like we need to basically just like pause life in general to take giant self-care steps. And so instead of doing that, I'm just trying to get a little bit better at learning how to self-care a bit more each day, and even while I'm doing things that aren't necessarily considered self-care. For instance, it's like if I'm editing a video, like get comfortable, edit your video with your glasses on, have a bottle of water beside you, like just little tiny things like that. They feel small and they might feel insignificant when you're first starting out. You might not feel like doing it, but I feel like it's honestly a matter of when you do, you just get that little burst of just like joy, that little burst of just like daylight, if you will. And then suddenly you're just starting to feel all around happier, more elated, more light. And one thing that I've been working a lot on writing. So even that's kind of been something that I've learned in September, is that I've also learned to take a chunk of time out every day to do something that is productive, but that isn't productive for the sake of work. It's kind of productive in a soul work kind of way, like do a little bit more soul work. And I've been getting all of these messages and just really, really channeling the idea that I need to be writing more. I don't know where exactly it was coming from, but I definitely just felt like I had kind of kept on pushing off writing because it didn't feel like it was something that needed to be done right now. And instead, I felt like my emotions, my soul, my whatever, were calling for it, but I was kind of ignoring that calling. And even that in itself, I think, is something that we can all agree to too, that that's part of the whole self-care, is that when you feel like your soul is calling for something, I definitely think that it's wise to answer. And so one habit that I started in September was to take an hour every single day, aside from the weekends, and write. And every single day that I write, there's a couple different things that I'm working on. But one thing in particular, I want to tell you guys so bad, but I honestly just want to wait until it's ready. But there's just one project that's so much closer to completion than I could have ever anticipated, solely just because of this month. And one thing that I recently wrote in it was that people that tend to feel heavier feelings, or that can get very, very in depth with their feelings, it's something that people shouldn't feel insecure about, i.e. myself, because I think that to feel that depth and to be able to kind of stand strong in feeling something that is so kind of intense, I also think that the pendulum swings the other way, which means that the happier you can feel. The second half of 2019, my pendulum has just been like, whoo, like way over in the daylight side of things. And so again, I didn't really have points for today's Koze Daily Brew, but I guess what I'm summing up here is that the whole self-care September was definitely a mood. I definitely think that I'm gonna find a way to trace it into the rest of the year as well, and find some other ways that I can kind of just relax, exhale a little bit while I expand a little bit, and recenter myself. Now I feel like the mood is kind of recentering for 2020, because there's so many incredible things that are coming that I'm just like really, I'm really excited about. And to know that I'm really excited without feeling like that burn of just like, get it done, get it done, get it done, get it done, like be productive. It's kind of instead just like, enjoy the process. Just enjoy the process. So I made it through a whole Koze Daily without saying at the end of the day, so can we just have a moment of applaud? And aside from that, I wanna know what this month has taught you guys. I also want to hear how excited you are for Utober, because it starts in 3 days. And last but not least, just yeah, leave all your comments down below of all the things you're excited for the rest of the year, all the things that September has taught you. And I hope you guys are ready to get spooky really soon. And with that, I'll talk to all of you guys tomorrow morning. Bye guys.